to hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger?
Like Uncle Pete. Every time I get plumb wore out, I think about you and Jotty and Daisy, and I ain't quite so tired no more.
Oh, Sam, I just never could get along without you.
Me too, honey. I couldn't live without you.
The thing we'd be good about is we could always work together. When you did the plow and I could lead the mules, and when you cleared up this brush, I could burn it for you. And in the summertime, we could lie in the grass and watch the kids swimming in the river.
Yeah, that'd be fun, honey. But what worries me is that busted well.
Oh, Sam, we could surely borrow water from the neighbor yonder. Ain't nobody refuses water.
Yeah, I hear he's got a good well.
Sam, I reckon we ought to stay.
You really mean that? You ain't just saying that to make me feel good.
I'm saying it because I believe you're as good as any man, and it's right for you to be your own boss.
Darling.
Hey, you two. You ain't all alone here, you know.
Hey there. We got a house. We're moving in and it's all iron. Come on, you possum. Help me. Give me a hand.
Here, you take the picture system. Mind you.
Mom,
drop
it. The table.
Come on, cutie, I'll help you down.
No, you don't. I don't aim to go no slew-footed. I can't even say it, being I'm a lady.
All right, old lady, but you better be down before morning, or you'll go right back to camp with this truck. No man Carrillo might not like it so much, neither.
Sam Tucker, my own grandson, gone crazy as a bedbug. Pure plum crazy, I tell you.
Crazy as a bedbug. He's gone completely silly, that boy. No more than a coot. Just plain out in his mind, I tell you. What little mind he ever done had. If he thinks he's gonna stick his old granny in a trash box like that, but ain't fitting for nothing more than kindling, he's sure got another thing coming. Downright mean. You gotta take out their cussedness on some of these old folks. Well, I done had my share, and I ain't taking no more, nohow, I tell you, no more.
They
ain't exactly a veranda, honey, but to me it's the porch that makes the house a home.
Sam, I think I got the stove working.
Oh, did you?
We'll all light it together.
Made a good job of that stove, honey.
Won't be long before we'll have a good hot cup of coffee.
You get some water, Sam. Johnny, Daisy, get the cups and put them on the table.
You reckon Granny's gonna stay out there all night?
Looks like that's gonna be took care of.
Sis, you go call Granny.
No, sir. Nothing what comes out of that old pot don't tempt me none at all.
You sit down, honey. I'll get it. Got your good blanket. Now put it around you before you catch your death of cold.
Here's some honey, Granny.
Honey. They not only let me die of the cold, but they hide out the goodies on me.
Color, honey.
The fire going, it's nice and warm in here.
you one, Sam.
Yeah, honey, that's a mighty fine fish.
It'll make us a good dinner.
Well, I figured I'd take this one to Devers. That neighbor ours down the road with a good well. That little one in the bucket's for us.
Aren't you going to put on dry clothes?
Oh, I'll dry off walking over. Won't be gone long. You better keep Zuni here.
This one ain't so big, honey. Come on, Jotty.
Well, Zuni? I'll catch us another one tomorrow. A big one. We'll keep it. Run along with your mama, Jotty. Mighty fine place you got around here. You the owner, you Henry Devers?
Nope, folks call me Finley.
Howdy.
Howdy. He's my uncle. He's over yonder in the shed.
Much obliged, Finley. Howdy.
What do you want?
I'm your neighbor. My name's Sam Tucker. I brought you a fish.
You mean don't want to buy it?
Oh, no, it's a present.
Well, leave it if you got no use for it.
Where'll I put it?
Any place, on the bench.
Say, that's a mighty queer-looking fish hook you're fixing.
I ain't no grabbler. I fish hook and line.
Aim to use it in this river?
Aim to use it any place I feel like it. Finley! Take this here fish, give it to Becky to cook for dinner.
You the new neighbor? I'm Becky Devers.
Yes'm, we're the Tuckers.
Been nice having folks next door. It's lonesome here.
What are you doing here? I didn't send for you.
But I thought Papa...
You don't have to think. Get that fish and go back in the house.
That fish a real fine fish.
And you get your washing finished.
My wife will likely be over soon to borrow some of your well water.
So that's what you come for?
That's right. My well ain't no good.
Yeah, I could have told you that.
Yeah, so can I, now. What about that water?
Why don't you get your water at the river?
Because river water ain't no good for kids to drink.
All right, as long as there's plenty of water. You'll have to make other arrangements, though, when summer comes. Gets pretty weak when the weather's dry. We'll take turns about replacing the wore-out rope.
Seems pretty wore out already.
Well, if you don't like it, next well's 5 miles down the road.
Suits me. All right. So long, Devers.
Just a minute. You're likely going to fix your own well, ain't you? If you're renting, you must have some savings put aside.
I got two good arms. It's worth more than savings.
Hear folks talk, you think they can be farmers just like that with the bare hands. Got any tools, a tractor?
No, I ain't got no tractor. But I got two mules and a good old plow, and a friend of mine's lending the seed.
The Rustin furnishes the fertilizer. Don't need much for good muddy land like that. And he gives the poison for the weevils, pays the cotton pickers, even lets you draw grub from his commissary after you get the ground broke. Yeah, he just furnishes about everything but the sweat. And if you get by the year, he generously lets you take your share of the crop. Ain't that right?
Why, ask me. Seems like you know it already.
No, but I know Rustin. Ain't the first time he's getting a piece of land cleaned off for nothing. Until you get your plowing started, how do you aim to eat?
I aim to fish and hunt varmints and sell a few skins. There are lots of folks like that live around here, and plenty more done it before. And how about you? How'd you get started?
Sharecrop. First year, I lost my whole crop. It was ruined by the hail. Next year, Blackleg got my cow and pig that I'd spent all my savings for. My wife caught cold and she died. 2 years later, one of my kids, the boy, he died from spring sickness.
Maybe I lost them both, my woman and my kid, because I didn't have no money for doctoring. And here I am with a farm. Good one, belongs all to me and worth lots of money. Only I can't forget what it cost me. So when I see young folk like you with their proudness, noses stuck in the air, just makes me laugh.
Well, much obliged for the water. And good luck with your fish hook. Hey, Finley.
Huh?
What's that big old fish hook your uncle's fixing up there? Is there a whale in this river?
That's for lead pencil.
Lead pencil? What's that?
A catfish. He's got chin whiskers like lead pencils. Biggest darn catfish you ever seen in the river.
Finley! Get that water!
Right away, Uncle Henry!
Hurry up and put your gas.
Over again.
Thank you, man.
Must be the wind.
It's more the signs. For days now, the moon's been moving closer and closer to the North Star. The animals don't like that. They hide out. Crazy to go against the signs, but what can you do? You gotta get fresh food.
Daisy, honey, why don't you and Sonny get into bed? It's nice and warm there. Come on, Daisy. Go to bed, Johnny.
You have a nice day at school, sister?
She didn't go, Sam.
Why not?
It's too cold. She ain't got no coat. She'll catch a death of cold.
But Daisy's got to go to school. Just because we're having hard times right now don't mean we got to stop nothing. We got to keep going. Once we give up, we won't have the courage to get ourselves back to good times.
And I see it ain't going to have no dinner again tonight.
Never you mind, Granny. For breakfast, we'll have a nice big bowl of cornmeal mush.
When you all look down on my cold, dead face in that county pine box, you'll be sorry then, maybe.
You keep on promising, Granny. You don't never deliver the goods.
Hush your mouth. You can't talk to me like that. You ain't even a real tucker.
Well, you ain't either.
Hey, honey. Daisy's got to be coated. You've got to go to school.
Don't you touch my blanket, Sam Tucker. Don't you touch my blanket. Sam Tucker, if you touch one thread of my best blanket, you get punishment.
Granny, ain't you got no heart? You want Daisy to catch a death? There'll be enough blanket to keep you warm.
I like a big cuss you, Sam Tucker. My beach blanket cuss you.
Granny.
Ben, my dear.
Sam Tucker's the boss here. He can cut up whatever he likes. He's the boss. You hear me?
Ben's blanket.
Oh, Granny. Now, don't take on this so. Look, I think I know where there's a nice swarm of wild bees. Maybe tomorrow I'll go out and get you some honey. Maybe.
Wild bees don't care for folks coming and helping themselves, you know.
Now, don't you worry. I'll get your honey.
Noni. You know, I guess you're right, Tucker, after all. And that Sam of yours, he's most as good a man as my Fayette.
My best blanket.
So that carcass of yours is sure gonna make four more tuckers.
Mighty happy. Oh, no. Come on, Zoom.
Yes, sir, your hat will just about bring the price of a pair of silk stockings for Nona. Nice and shiny.
Reckon we can eat now, folks.
I want a leg.
Easy, you'll all get your share.
Hold on, everybody. There's going to be a blessing.
Much obliged, Lord. Looks like the Tuckers are going to make the grade after all. Amen.
Granny gets the first because she's the eldest.
I'd taken the Lord to be a stranger in this house.
Then comes Jotty, because he's the littlest. Then comes Papa, because he caught the possum. And this one's for Zuni, because he helped him. And last of all, Daisy and me, because we're the women folk.
They say this kind of food's bad for you all the time. They say you gotta eat vegetables. Too much meat's bad.
Vegetables in winter?
If you don't, they say you get pellagra.
That must be spring sickness, Sam.
Well, it's vegetables that causes spring sickness. That's when you get it along about the time you start eating vegetables.
I ought to know. I lost three of mine from it. Your Uncle Walter, Aunt Bet and Sue, and not one of them was over six.
Oh, shucks, look at him. Anything a body likes as good as that couldn't be bad for him. Ain't that true, Noma?
That's right, Sam.
Thank you.
done all that ourselves. Just kept working and plugging away, and by gosh, we done good. Before long now, we can start planting our cotton around about the twin days. And our crop will really get started. See those little green woolly worms falling out of that tree 10 a minute? They're all drifting down together to the same place. And some folks might think that they're what Lead Pencil's after. But they'd be wrong. Because he's after something else. He ain't interested in no worms. Old Lead's a pretty smart old guy. Wouldn't hardly live to be as old as he is if he wasn't. I'll bet you old Lead waits for his dinner right over yonder with that there drift. It's like a trap on the river bottom.
Is Lead Pencil older than Granny, Papa?
Yes, he's older than Granny. Yes, sir? It must be yonder. Old Lead Pencil's got his cupboard. Give me that, honey.
No better than me. It's already lost three from it. Sam, I'm afraid.
No reason to bother you, Doctor. It was just a little sore. Sonny ain't ever been sick. But it grew and grew. Now it seems like it's just plumb gonna possess him. You see it, Doctor? It's like some evil crawling worm eating up our baby. I can't stand to watch it no longer, Doctor. You gotta do something to stop it.
Have a cow, do you?
No, sir.
Well, you better tell Sam to get one.
How can we get a cow?
Borrow one. Let Sam raise a heifer for somebody. Or borrow some milk anyway. A pint a day. Or better still, a quart. Any neighbor with a cow could spare you that.
I'll try, Doctor. What medicine?
Undress the boy. what vegetables you been eating lately?
Vegetables? Couldn't grow vegetables in winter.
You got any money?
Yes, Doctor. I got your $2, and Sam's got $1.35 more.
Keep it. You take all your money and spend it all for vegetables, and get some lemons. Give him a glass of lemonade twice a day, and get that milk, you hear? If you don't give him milk and vegetables, anything that I can do will be just plumb wasted.
And with the milk and vegetables?
I think he's got a chance.
Thank you. Call again. Me, I know a war is. When we was right close to Shadow Theory, the old colonel, he brung us all together, and he said...
He said, young men, in civilian life, never brag about your conquests, whether they be love
Shut
or
up,
war.
Shut up, young fella. I'm telling you, I know. And I know I know.
Hi, Miss Bird.
Hey, how are you?
Well, if it ain't Sam Tucker. Okay.
What, Tim, when did you get in town?
How much for these here pipe cleaners?
10 cents, ma'am.
Ain't they gone up? It used to be a nickel.
No, ma'am. Old Z could be mighty pleased with them, ma'am. Tim just came back to show off his city clothes.
Yeah, just take a look at that fancy tie. Seems like in the city, dollars grow faster than beans in the field.
Don't pay no mind to them yokels.
Sam, I've been looking all over for you. Let's go over to Seaman's and I'll buy us a beer and tell you all about it.
Brother, I'm with you anytime you'll buy me a beer. Well, Harmy, Nona and Jot over at Doc White's. When they come over, tell them I'll be back in a minute, will you?
Yeah. I know what a minute means when you're drinking beer with old Timmy there.
How much for this pair of garters?
You said Nona and Jot is over to old Doc White's?
Yeah.
What's wrong, Sam?
Well, that Jot is ailing. Granny says it's spring sickness. Yeah, poor Nona. The sick kid, she don't hardly get a wink of sleep.
Yeah, it's tough, man.
And my mom came out to my place yesterday to help. Harmon brought her out in his truck. Well, that's kind of a relief.
Sam.
Hello, Tim.
Howdy, pal.
Hello, Sam. How's Nona?
She's fine, thank you, ma'am.
Eddie. Hey, would you be interested in coming work in the factory with me?
Are you crazy? What would I do in a factory? I'm a farmer.
Well, they just opened a new plant, and they're just crying for men. Don't even have to be skilled. I know the foreman. I'll get you in a minute.
Pay much?
$7 a day.
$7 a day?
Howdy, gents. What'll it be?
Ain't you new here?
What'll it be?
Okay, big shot. 2 bottles of beer.
Sure is hot in here. What about a beer for me? I'm mighty thirsty.
Well, why don't you ask your sweet papa there? He gets it wholesale.
Oh, him. This ain't one of his good days. Must have got out of bed on the wrong side.
Well, I got out on the right side. Bartender, another beer.
Handsome. Ain't I seen you someplace before?
No? What'd you say?
I asked you. Ain't I never seen you someplace before?
Could be, I don't know.
You in town all alone?
Oh, no, ma'am. Well, like you see, I'm with my friend here, and my wife's waiting for me at Harmy's door.
Oh, so you got a wife?
Yep, I got a wife.
Well, someone's got wives, and it's still nice and friendly.
I'm sorry, ma'am, I was studying about something.
Let's go down to the end of the bar, pal. We can't talk here.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I ain't got no wife waiting for me, baby. How about a date tonight?
You big pig. You know what you can do with your dates.
Okay. Okay, baby. We'll talk about it later.
Here you go.
To your kids, Sam.
$7 a day, huh?
So it's yes, you come?
Well, don't rightly see how I can, Tim. I made a deal with Rustin. I already got some credit from his commissary.
Man, with $7 a day, wouldn't take you long to pay him back.
Yeah, but I'm telling you, Tim, this is the first time I've been able to farm my own crop, just like I always wanted to. That ain't something I can give up just like that.
Well, how much can you get on your crop?
Man, with that ground I got, it'll be the finest crop in the country.
Well, what does that mean, the finest crop in the country?
With any luck at all, I can make 2 bales an acre.
Well, how much does that make for you?
More than 50 bales.
No, I mean how much money?
Do you know that on that ground that I've been working on now, old man Corinth made a fortune in the last cotton boom, a real fortune.
Oh, so that's the idea. All you farmers is just the same. Gamblers.
That's what you all are, to a man. Year after year, you starve yourself to death in hopes that some fine day...
Well, I think you're loco.
Me, I'd rather be safe first.
Me, I'd rather work in my field. I feel better that way. I feel more free.
Free? Free? Man, with money in your pocket, you're as free as the wind. With this, you want a good meal, you go to a restaurant. Good room, you go to a hotel. All you got to do is flash your greenback. You get anything you want. You call that free, sweating from morning till night in the baking hot sun working in them fields?
Oh, I allows how it's sometimes pretty hard. But what I mean is being able to decide things for myself. I know I can choose my own time about planting and plowing and harvesting my crop. And that I can do it all in my own way and don't have to answer to nobody. I mean, for me alone to be accountable for it. Whether the weevils strip it clean or whether it's the best crop.
And all that baloney, that means no.
Afraid so, Tim.
Well, pal, I think you're making a big mistake.
Hey, bartender, where's my other $4?
What $4?
I'll give you a $5 bill.
Oh, no. Lizzie, you seen that was a one.
Of course I did. And that pretty boy that's going home to his wife, he sees it too.
Well, I'll be doggone. So that's how it is. Nothing but a hickey old farmer, and yet the girls fall for you like a ton of bricks. What in the heck have you got that I can't buy with my dough? Give me my $4, you big double-jointed son of a skunk, or I'll tear this joint.
Hey, outside.
Okay, brother. But I hope it's going to be worth the $4 to you.
What are you aiming to do, Tim?
I ain't asking you to help, Sam. You got a family.
I wouldn't start no trouble, Sam.
Now, don't stay here, Sam.
This is apt to cost you more than $4.
I'm asking you, please, not to stay here.
Man done said about little Jot. Just like to see him get them vegetables to grow. Where do you figure we're going to get that there milk from? Out in the sky, just like that. Oh, shuckins.
Seems like Sam ain't the only pig-headed one around here. That maw of his. Think she can cure the spring sickness with fresh air. Oh, with a lady her age ought to have better sense. Me? I say that baby will just catch his death in this here wind.
A
coming to get that milk.
Poor Sam.
Males in this here Tucker family just ain't strong.
No, sir. It's just like I told you, Tucker. I don't need no extra help. I got Finley and my gal Becky. Too bad about your boy. I know what that is, a sick kid, pretty sorrowful. Whip some in, Becky. But I told you before, it's wrong for a man to get too big for his britches. When you got no money, you work for them what's got it. That there's the rule. Why don't you go back to Ruston? Get your 6 bits a day, some milk for your chap, maybe some doctoring even. About the milk, like you see, I can't rightly spare a drop. Me, I got no milk for myself. It's all for the pigs. Throw the rest in, Becky. Henley, bring the grain. Your cotton. Coming along, not too many bugs. I seen you the other day in the field. You were shaving that cotton so close to the ground with the plow, you scared me. Still, that's the best way to get rid of the bugs. Rolls them right out in the sun. The heat kills them better than any poison. But you gotta have a good eye and a steady hand. You're a good worker, all right, Tucker. If I was you, I wouldn't think twice. I'd go back to work for Ruston.
If I wanted to give up, I wouldn't have to go back to Ruston.
Got something better?
Yeah, lots better. Like I already done told you, I want to grow my own crop, and I aim to do it.
Well, if you're so sure of yourself, why are you always coming around asking the neighbors for help?
Have I ever asked you for anything? Likely some old-fashioned idea I had about neighborliness. Well, take good care of them pigs.
That's sure what I'm going to do. I see that that black hog eats all his dinner, you hear?
Go on, Devers.
I can get you some more every once in a while. My daddy won't ever see.
I'm much obliged, Becky, and I'll take it, because my boy's really bad off. But I'll pay you for it.
Becky, I've seen you. I've seen what you've done.
I feel just like breaking somebody's neck today.
I'm going to tell your pa you were stealing his milk. I knowed you was hankering after this fella. I've seen you looking at him before. I'm going to tell your pa.
Oh, what did you do that for? I ain't never going to speak to you again.
If I see you talking to him again, you'll be sorry.
Get Finley. Don't fret, Becky. You're a good gal, and thanks just the same.
Honey? Nona. Nona. Oh, Nona, honey, Nona.
I can't listen to him cry no more.
Lord, how come you put that sky up there in this old mud down here? Made it so pretty if you didn't want us to work it and to love it. You want me to give all this up? Move in town with Tim and work with him in a factory under a roof that hides your sky and puts out your light? Tell me, Lord, help me to know.
She had a fine trip. She's a wonderful old cow.
You have a good trip to me.
Yeah, you know, Harmony, a cow's the only thing I love in the country that I miss the city.
Believe you me, that sweet old gal's a lot more gentler than that Lizzie at the saloon.
Oh.
Harmony, can I go town now?
Oh, of course you can.
That Harmony. He'd come wagging in one of these days with a boa constrictor. I wouldn't be one mite surprised.
Uncle Walter.
Garden?
That's Finley and them's Devers' cattle.
You go on back in the house, honey. Go on back in the house.
Finley, what do you know about this?
I don't know nothing. I didn't do it.
No, not by yourself, but we both know who did. Come on, we're going to your place. Devers, look, I said, why'd you do it?
What do you mean, why'd I do it? You can't prove nothing. Law will call it an act of God. As for your garden, you can plant it again, can't you?
Plant it again?
Or did you come to borrow some seed?
I wouldn't borrow from
Wait
you.
Wait a minute. Speaking of borrowing, this rope's plumb ruined. Remember what we agreed on when you first come and asked for water?
You mean about replacing
it? Yeah, about replacing it. It's time for you to do it now. I don't aim to use this one no more. And I'm sick and tired of you coming around here and asking for water.
And now, Devers, I'm going to break your neck. I'm mighty glad you started this, Tucker.
especially with Finley here as a witness. That makes two of us can talk to the law.
Your mouth, get back in the house.
You'd like to see me leave her, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Of course I would.
What'd I ever do to you?
Like I told you.